Welcome back to CAD CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create a simple male union T adapter in SOLIDWORKS. See, this is a simple brass fitting, so I hope you like it. Here we will learn some basic commands of basic feature commands in SOLIDWORKS. I hope you like it. So let's start to create this one. It looks very open file, new, and choose your part. Okay, now we are going to create male union T adapter. So first we will choose real view. Okay, now first we will change the dimension, keep inches because we have dimension on inches. So let's start with front plane sketch. Now arrow goes this direction, so simply select normal 2. So we want arrow this direction, then we will start our geometry, corner rectangle. Okay, then draw a center line, make sure it is parallel to this line. Keep this point here, it is very useful because we need to create a plane, so that point we will utilize. Choose these two points, horizontal dimension. Let's define 0.625 inches. Sorry, 0.65265 inches. Okay, (0.9 inches). That's it. Now the distance from here to this line, this is 1.81 inches. Okay, now this overall length, this is also same 1.81 inch. it is not matter whatever line you can define, we just defined it to make our geometry become fully defined. Now better to do one thing, drag this point, same thing, you can drop one point here, 1.81. Even let's say you can define, choose these two points horizontal, so our geometry is fully defined. See, go to feature and choose revolve boss base, and I'll choose this one. See, okay, let me hide real view. Choose this face sketch, click convert entity. Now this circle is converted, this outer edge is converted into line. Go to curve and choose helix and spiral. Here we want to create a thread path. First we need to create a thread. For thread we need a path. See, it's going reverse direction, so keep your height and pitch. Height, let's say 0.98, actually it is a full length, so 6 times 3. Then the pitch 0.0836 times, and make reverse direction so that it will move, and keep counterclockwise. Okay, again edit and see the angle. Okay, let me choose here front plane, choose sketch normal. Now for here we need to create a thread profile. Okay, now choose this center point to this center point. Exit. Now select this line, vertical relation, then again construction geometry. Now select these three lines. Create relation symmetric. Now define. Connect one center line also. Choose this is the center point to this center point. Make sure this line also horizontal, this also horizontal. It's time to define. First we will define angle 60 degree. Okay, now this length, this is a important length, 0.0416666, 4 × 6 = 7 inches. Okay, it's time to bottom line. Bottom line 0.0104667 inch. Okay, now choose this curve, hold shift key and select this point and choose pierce. Now see, our drawing is fully defined. Isometric view, exit, go to feature and choose swift cut. Now see, the profile is selected here. You need to choose path, so simply select this path. Once you choose this path, it will show you a preview. Now here you can see the preview, so click OK. Now it takes few seconds, so that now see, it is calculated. Let me hide, choose this one, hide. Now you can see the thread. Keep isometric view. Now it's time to extend. Now we need to create a plane, so just simply select first sketch, show. Now choose your plane. For reference purpose choose right plane, and in second reference choose this point. See here in this line we want to create a plane. Okay, now choose this plane. A sketch, normal. Okay. Now, let me choose here polygon. We will keep 6 number of polygons. Exit. Let me define. (1.3125 inches). Now choose this line, keep relation vertical. Now see, this is fully defined. Select extruded boss base and choose here up to vertex. Even you can choose this face, or even if you don't want to choose, choose up to next. If not going to show next, click up to surface, choose this surface. That's it. Now let me hide this. Okay, now let's hide all the things, hide this geometry also. Now we need to make some cutout, so again we will choose front plane. This position seems better. Choose center line and connect up to from here to this end. Now choose this line, make relation horizontal line. Connect. Don't make any relation. connect up to here, this line and this point. Exit. Draw one center line. This is for reference purpose, because we want to make revolve cut against this. Okay, choose this line horizontal, choose these two lines, make relation collinear. Okay, distance, this line to this upper line, it is difficult to choose this outer line. You can see these lines. Let me create a center line. Up to here. It is quite difficult to choose. So what we will do? We want little distance. .06. Now that's too that's fine. 5.5. .0625 inches. Okay, now let's do the same for this. 45 inches. Now distance from the .91996 by 2 inches. .125 inches. And let's define this angle 37 degree. See, our geometry is fully defined. Go to feature, choose revolve cut. Now here axis of revolution, choose this center line and you can see the preview. Okay, that's it. Again choose revolve, front plane, sketch, normal, choose your line, and here also we need to cut some cutout. Exit. Center line. Choose this upper line, difficult to choose, but you can choose. Hold shift key and this line collinear. Okay. This angle seems 30 degree. Okay. Now draw one center line. Go to feature, choose revolve cut. Axis of revolution, choose this line. You can see the preview. Okay. Now select this face, sketch, normal, and let me create a hole here, circle. and keep the diameter 0.844 inches. Select extruded cut and keep dimension through all. Okay. Now that's it. Now let me choose this face sketch normal. Now choose your center line. Draw one center line from here to this point, because here we want to create an axis, and this axis will help us to make multiple number of patterns. Now exit this line. Now choose here axis line, one line edges. So I'll directly choose this one. You can see one line edges axis selected. Okay, now this is now axis. Now we need to make multiple number of patterns, so choose circular pattern. Here choose axis 180 degree, keep equal spacing 180 degree, three number of patterns, and here choose body and choose this body. Now you can see how is going to convert into three bodies. See, we kept 180 degree, three number of patterns, equal spacing, and we here we choose body so that it will convert whole body into three parts. Uncheck this one. Okay, now let's see, it is perfectly that's fine. Let's hide this axis and sketch also. But here you will see three bodies, 1, 2, 3. So we need to make one body, so go to insert feature and choose here combine option, select add and select 1, 2, 3, all three body choose, keep add. Okay, now see, it's become one body. Here you will no more see three bodies, but still some things need to cut from the inside. So directly choose this face sketch normal, and let me choose this corner convert entity feature and select extruded cut. Here select through all so that it will cut up to the end. Okay, my computer is slow, so that's why it's going to okay. Now this is also blocked from the top, so top sketch, select inside circle, convert entity, feature and extruded cut. And this time what we will choose, up to surface, and which surface, up to inside surface. You can see preview is going to cut up to here. Okay, that's it. See, the cutout is created. So this is how we created a male Union T adapter. Let real view and define some material. We will choose bronze, that's fine. Okay, that's look fine, brushed bronze. So I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.